Today on Tech Bytes, I'm talking to Matthew Brennan about using unmanned aerial systems in teaching and research at Indiana University.
The most important thing about applying technologies to the humanities is that it's not replacing any of those traditional fields, it's just augmenting them. So it's providing new tools and new approaches that allow for greater accessibility and greater understanding. My name is Matthew Brennan. I'm in the School of Informatics here at Indiana University, and I'm a research faculty member. Well, archaeology has always been heavily reliant upon photographs because it's by its nature, a destructive process. You're digging into the earth and destroying the stratigraphy of the soil and the objects that are buried there. So it was always very important to take really good photographs of the process so that you had these snapshots, essentially, of the object you were removing from the earth. So photo modeling is a process that involves the reconstruction of camera locations based on a series of photographs taken of an object. So if you took 200 photographs of a building, the software would be able to compare similar points between all those photos and reconstruct essentially the positions of the cameras and thereby the geometry that was being photographed. So you're able to get a highly accurate 3D model of anything you photographed. So the better camera you have, the more accurate the 3D model. The process for using the UAV for photo modeling is essentially the same as if you were photographing by hand. The benefit of using a UAV rather than handheld photography or having to shoot from an airplane is that they're relatively inexpensive and they allow you to get a view and take a photo from a height that you would never be able to get. I think UAVs could be used in a wide variety of fields, particularly geography and sort of the study of land masses at a relatively small scale, maybe a mountain or a valley, but also in agriculture, measuring drought effects and crop health. They're beginning to be used in those fields as well. I've probably flown it more than 200 flights, and I've never had really a close call or anything. I had previous experience with radio-controlled cars and airplanes from when I was a kid, and I imagine playing video games a lot also helps with sort of having a hand-eye coordination and sense of space that isn't just around yourself, but around whatever you're controlling. But I wouldn't say it was particularly hard, which is why I think so many people are using them now. You should definitely try it.
If you're interested in seeing more from the Virtual World Heritage Laboratory, be sure and check out the links below.